back to another how-to episode. I'm Kirsten Stone, and today we're going to be doing an imitation video of how to paint like Bob Ross. It's going to be a very easy, very simple video. This will be our painting today. It's just a sunset coming up in the woods. So let's get started. So for today's painting, we will be using gold, black, white, blue, and purple. Alright, so to start off this painting, we're just going to take a little bit of white here and outline where our background will be against the sky. Don't worry about messing it up because we'll come back and fill it in later. So we'll just make a quick little brush stroke in here. And that'll be good. And we'll get just a little bit more to fade it up in here. We're going to mix it with some blues here in a second. Okay. Next, we will take our blue that we've previously picked out. We'll put it just above it, following all of the same patterns. Make sure you get a little bit of it in there so it mixes together nice, easy. We'll also be taking the blue and making just little marks throughout the rest of our sky so it'll fade up and we'll have that nice little sunrise effect. We don't want it too thick and everywhere, so we're just going to keep it nice and light in certain areas. And then we will take our purple, and we'll go ahead and mix that more closer to the top. Alright, so I've already finished the top part of the painting on the sky. That's all we're going to do to it, and we're just going to leave it for now. Next, we're going to do some gold down here for the landscape, like the grass and everything, so it's highlighted. So we'll just go ahead and start with that. So you get a little bit of gold on your brush, not too much. You don't want it showing up too much in there, but we'll just go ahead and somehow. Now this one you need to make sure is exactly the same as your landscape, almost. There can be a couple variations within it, but we'll just try and keep it the same as for now, as much as we can, just to keep it just the way the grass grows. Make sure I get some here right near the top, just because that's where the sun will be hitting the most. Make sure it's nice and highlighted, just like that. Continue this down the rest of the page. Alright, next we will be making just a couple small trees along the skyline to just kind of polish it off and not give it just such a flat effect here. So, we're going to take our black and go ahead and re-outline them first. So, we'll just make one, two, make that one a little taller, and three. We're going to do five total, so we're going to put two on the other side. Just do a small little background one, right here. Okay, so now that we have where the trunks are, we're just gonna do a little bit in here. We're just gonna take our brush and kind of brush it side to side. You can make your trees as thick and full as you'd like. I like my trees to be pretty full, like a happy little Christmas tree. And don't worry about them being too dark, because we're going to go over that in just a second. your trees. Okay, now that we've let our trees dry a little bit, we're gonna go back in with the gold and highlight over them so you can see the outline of them better. So, it's gonna be the exact same technique as we just used on the trees. We're just gonna do it with a little bit of gold instead. And we're not gonna do like the whole thing, but we're gonna do a lot of it. Just because. We still want some of the black to show through. Just like that. Next one. You can go ahead and let it fade down farther at the bottom so it shows up just a little bit less. So when the sun comes up, it's really going to be hitting the top of the trees more than it will anywhere else. Get our smaller trees in here. And last one. That's done. We're going to take the biggest brush that you've used all night, and we're going to put little white dots across there just for stars. Now, if you'd like to make this a little bit more of a Christmas painting, you can go ahead and add white all over just like if they're snowflakes. Personally, I like the stars, so I'm going with stars. But you're just going to take the end of your brush and just dot it right across the skyline. No particular order, we're just going to randomly throw some on there just a bit. You can make them just different sizes, because not all stars are the same. Get a couple smaller ones over here. All right, and that concludes our painting for today. Thank y'all for watching.